Hello and welcome back to Switch and Lever. The world of speakers is vast and filled with both everything from gimmicks all the way to truly great speakers. It's also filled with arrogance, prestige, and more money than you could shake out of a 17th century pirate. But I believe that having fun in making is more important than catering to audiophiles. A recent addition that made the rounds and became quite successful on Kickstarter is a specific brand of transparent speaker. But when seeing it, I couldn't stop myself from thinking, how hard could making a transparent speaker really be? For this build, I decided not to make the whole system myself, but rather buy one of these cardboard Bluetooth speaker kits from a local store. They're cheap and the audio isn't the best, but it does what it says on the tin, or on the cardboard. It can be powered either with battery or with USB, but to keep this build as clean as possible, we're entirely foregoing the battery pack. The plastic knob will also be replaced with a nicer aluminum knob later in the build. What we're left with are just the two speaker drivers and the Bluetooth amplifier board with the necessary cabling. I'm a firm believer in using the tools you have access to, and since I have access to a laser cutter, that's what I'll use. I'm definitely not going to start cutting and joining panes of glass to make this speaker, but instead I model the speaker up and cut out the necessary pieces out of 3mm acrylic. If you don't have a laser cutter, you could by all means either outsource a job like this to an online service like Ponoco, or you could manually cut out all the pieces by hand. Acrylic is beneficial since it's quite easy to glue, if you have the right adhesive. I'm using an Acrifix adhesive that works mainly in softening the plastic using a solvent and allows it to bond with itself as the solvent evaporates. This can also be done with other solvents like acetone or chloroform. Since this glue is also free-flowing, the easiest way to apply it is to first put the pieces together dry and then use a pipette, a syringe or a soaked Q-tip and allow the glue to be pulled into the joint with capillary forces. I would not under any circumstances recommend using super glue to glue this. The glue basically sits in between the acrylic pieces, creating a brittle joint. The outgassing of the super glue when it dries can also leave hazy remnants on the acrylic plastic. The Acrifix glue leaves completely invisible joints if applied properly, and even if you spill glue elsewhere on the acrylic, it will not ruin the finish as long as you leave it alone and let it evaporate. That also means that you can reposition the pieces to get them into position before the glue fully bites without making a mess. An added benefit is that the glue joint is basically just acrylic welded to itself, so the joint is as strong, if not stronger, than the surrounding material. I'm adding threaded inserts into a bezel to be able to add a back piece that is removable if need be once everything is mounted. The bezel is glued in the same way as the other pieces. The Bluetooth amplifier board will be mounted into another bezel at the bottom of the enclosure and held in place to be able to plug in a USB cable once everything is done. Before installing everything into the enclosure, we need to desolder and move the combined volume and on-off switch away from the circuit board and extend it with some wires to be able to use it from outside the enclosure. From here on, all the work inside the speaker will be done with gloves, as once we start mounting things inside, it will be increasingly difficult to wipe away fingerprints, which will ruin the look of our finished speaker. The speaker drivers are simply screwed in from the back. A little blue tack on the nut helps to start it in a tight enclosure like this. I'm also using nylock nuts to make sure that they stay in place over time and won't loosen from vibration. The amplifier board goes in and is held in place with another glued piece of acrylic, which slightly overlaps the circuit board, preventing it from moving around. The switch is installed on the side, with the aforementioned aluminum knob mounted on the shaft. only thing left is to connect the speakers and finally close up the box. This could indeed have been a beautiful cardboard speaker, but I hope you agree that a transparent speaker is at least a little bit more attractive. It's a speaker that truly will blend in regardless of which environment you put it in. I'm sure you could build a higher quality little speaker if you felt like spending more money on the contents, but for what it is, I'm not complaining. The Bluetooth works flawlessly, which unfortunately I cannot say for every speaker I've tried, and the sound is surprisingly decent for a speaker this size. Previously on this channel, I made another speaker, using mainly material salvaged from electronics garbage. So if you're interested in speaker builds, be sure to check that out as well. There is also a positive throng of other videos on a wide variety of subjects on this channel. So if this video wasn't up your proverbial alley, I'm sure you could find something which is. Hop on over to the Switch and Lever Instagram page for more material that just doesn't make it to YouTube. Thanks for watching! Until next time!